Good afternoon. Hi, this is Indira Shah here. Today, I just want to show you how to grow a coffee plant. Okay? When I say coffee plant, yes, all South Indians will be grinning because the moment you get up, after you brush, you will have your hot decoction coffee. So, growing coffee here in Bangalore, it's really because Bangalore weather is friendly for most of the plants. And you know, somebody asked me from Hyderabad and Delhi if they can grow coffee. Yes, you can always try. You know, trying doesn't, bother. So you can certainly grow coffee plant. I'll just show you how to grow a coffee plant in a container, okay? Here, this is the coffee plant. Here you can see. You can see the berries here, 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 everywhere, here. Can you see here? Berries and the fruits here. See, this is the fruit. Okay, you can see the red berry here. Fruit, see how huge the plant is. This is around 10 feet from the ground. 10 feet from the ground. And berries all over, all over. Bring it down. Just see. Here. I'm growing this in a 20-liter paint bucket. This is a paint bucket. And this is growing in a paint bucket. See, I'm not growing it in a large drum or on the ground. This is growing with me for the past 6 to 8 years and giving me lots of fruits, lots of fruits. See, when you drink your coffee from the bean grown by you, I'll tell you the satisfaction that you get is something I just can't explain, beyond my one's dream, I can say. See, I may not get 8 to 10 kgs, I get around 1 kilo certainly, but this year, you know, the harvest is little less. It looks little less, but I certainly get a kilo. And when I go to the store where, you know, they fry and powder it for me, you know, even the storekeeper many times ask me, how do you grow this? Now I'll tell you how to grow a coffee in a container. Here, see, what you do is take a bucket. Okay, and you have to make underneath this, I have made 3 holes, okay, the drainage holes, that is very important. A drainage hole is very important. Once you make the hole, cover it with a slab, okay, with any stone slab, anything. Do not, cover it completely, because when the water is excess, it should be able to drain out. So you cover it in such a way. Once you cover it, then the medium that you need to fill in the bucket is 2 parts of soil. Here, this is the soil. Just to show you, I have filled it here. 2 parts of soil. And for coffee, you need again 2 parts of cocoa peat. This is cocoa peat. I'll tell you why 2 parts of cocoa peat. And then again 2 parts of compost. Here, this is the compost that is made by me. I do not throw any kitchen waste. Not a grain of rice goes out of my house. Everything I convert it into a beautiful compost, which my plants love it. Okay? So what you do is mix all these 3. 2, 2, 2. That is 1, 1, 1. Equal part, I can say. But in this case, you can add little more compost. The reason is, coffee is actually, you can use it as an indoor plant, because this plant loves semi-shade. It just doesn't like to grow under a hot sunlight, hot sun. Okay, I have tried it also, shifting to your hot sun just to check how it stays, but no. The next day I could see, you know, all the leaves were just hanging, facing down. So I realized that they don't like sunlight. So they like semi sunlight, and you can even keep it as an indoor plant. And but they need to get at least sunlight, from the window or from the main door, wherever it is. Okay, and the coffee plant loves moisture always. Okay, see here, it should be always, there should be water in the sense. When I'll just show you. See, when you prick it, it should go inside. So it should be moist. The soil must be moist, but there should not be any stagnant. There should not be water stagnating in it. Okay. So they love always, to be the top layers to be wet. So that is the reason we put cocoa. We add more cocoa pit because cocoa pit helps to retain the moisture level in this soil, which the coffee plant loves it. Okay, if I love keeping indoor plants. I have already kept one indoor plant, coffee plant, inside my house, but it doesn't give much fruit as this plant gives. So that is the reason I have this matured plant under the semi shade. Okay, this is semi shade. See, you can see here up. See, there's a shade here and here. So there's no direct sunlight as such. So this is the soil medium that coffee plant loves. After you sow the plant, again let me just tell you how to propagate. Okay, propagations are through the seeds here. See, this is the seed, coffee bean. Okay, allow it to ripen much more. Once it completely ripe and dries, you can just sow this with the same medium. I told you equal, and this you can, the cocoa peat you can add little more because they like moisture. Okay, they don't like dry soil. They always like moisture. So you can sow it, and within 10 to 15 days you can see the sprout. Once you get 6 leaves from the seed that you have sown, then you can transplant it to a little bigger pot. If you want, you can use clay pot or mud pot or cement pot or a plastic pot or a plastic bucket, anything, whatever you wish. If you want to keep it inside the house, then you can use a beautiful clay pot, mud pot. Mud pot is always better. I always say mud pot is eco-friendly and it's good. I usually don't like the plastic one because, since we are all environmentalists, we don't like the plastic. But I had no choice. Since I'm growing this on the terrace, I have used the plastic. Okay, so once you transplant it, see that immediately after transplanting, you keep them die under indirect sunlight. Do not expose them into the sunlight. Okay, so the one is through seed you can grow. The second thing is air layering is also another way of propagating. See, you have to choose a thick stem like this. Okay, you can follow my YouTube channel for air layering. There's a process which is a really easy way of propagating. So through air layering also you can propagate. But you get lots of saplings everywhere. You can buy a sapling, or maybe once this fruits, I can certainly share seeds to all of you. You all can grow coffee. So once you grow coffee, after 3 or 4 years, you will start getting buds. But before that, I just want to tell you, how to grow the coffee, with so many stems like this. This is automatically, the stems comes. But when the plant is small, you have to adopt pinching method. What is pinching method? When the plant comes to this height, from the bucket, this height, you need to pinch here. See, this is the shoot, new shoot. Just pinch it like this. Do not use scissor, just use this. Once you pinch here, automatically another stem comes from here. So this is how we try to grow a plant you know, if you like to have a bushy plant, okay? So you can adopt the pinching method. So once it reaches this much, then you can keep them under, you know, not under direct sunlight, wherever you want, but below a place where the sun is not direct, okay? So after 3-4 years of sowing, you will start getting flowers. See, flowers will start from here to here, from here to here. The complete, you know, it will be like a bouquet, and the, what you call, the aroma, the fragrance will be awesome. You know, once the coffee flower starts flowering, you can see lots of bees and butterflies sitting and certainly enjoying. I think the fragrance of this flower invites the bees and the butterflies. See, I am on the second floor, but every day you can expect bees and butterflies, you know, jumping here and there and enjoying. I can see the you know, happiness when I see the bees and the butterflies, you know, sitting on each flower and sucking the nectar. So pollination is not a problem. If you find there are no pollinators, then hand pollination is the best. But trust me, till today I have not hand pollinated at all. Pollination is in the natural method. When the flower comes, I swear, it, you know, even you will start getting the fragrance, you know, about 1/2 kilometer away, you can certainly smell it. You will certainly know that there's a coffee flower around. The fragrance will be excellent. So, but once, you know, you get the flower, now you can add more compost, okay? Every 15 days or 20 days, you can, put some, you can add some compost, homemade compost, vermicompost, or the sheep manure. I love sheep manure because I have been putting sheep manure plus the home compost. And, you know, certainly with sheep compost, this grows so well. Do not add chemical. Do not stick on to any a type of chemical fertilizers or sprays or pesticides, anything. Till today, I have not faced any pesticide problem. I swear, this is 6 to 8 years old, I have not faced any type of pest attack. So, even if you have pest attack, you can apply, neem spray or GGG, that is ginger, garlic and green chili. Take equal amount, grind them to a fine paste, then strain it, and that solution you can spray on to the pest, okay? So this is how a coffee is grown. See, once the berries are red and it's, you know, it starts turning brown, starts drying, then you can harvest them, remove the outer skin, take it to your shop where, you know, a coffee blender can certainly blend it into a powder and enjoy your coffee. Certainly, I always add chicory with the coffee powder. I add around 20% of chicory to, 80% of coffee powder, because that gives me a strong South Indian perfect coffee. So those who ask, those the Delhi, my friends from Delhi and Hyderabad ask me if they can grow. You can grow. Please follow the way that I have explained. You can certainly grow. I can share some beans to you, coffee beans to you, not only to you, to anyone who wants. So this time no coffee powder for me. I'm going to share the seeds to all of you. So I think all of you, by next year, you must be able to grow the coffee plant, which is, you know, very friendly, eco-friendly. See, you can see the height. Can you see the berries here? Bring it close. Here. The berries, lots of berries. You know, when you just taste the coffee powder will be bit. When you taste the coffee powder, the coffee powder tastes bitter, like cocoa powder, you know. But when you eat the fruit, see, when you eat the fruit, I just take one. Here, when you eat the fruit is, that is outer skin or the pulp inside is very sweet. Even the cocoa is like that. When you eat the cocoa powder, it is bitter to the core. But then when you eat the cocoa fruit, oh my God, it is so sweet. So see how nature takes you, how it, you know, shows its color. So, you know, you can, trust me, you can sort, all of you can grow coffee powder. Please grow it by yourself. Do not use any sort of chemical in either pesticide or the manure, whatever it is. So be eco-friendly, make your own compost. Do not throw any wet waste, okay? So this is the responsibility of every Indian citizen, okay? So thank you very much for watching my video. Hope to see you all growing coffee. And if you want any seed, please contact me. I shall certainly share with you. Thank you very much.